Good morning. A woman picked a fight with me a few days ago. She had picked a fight with me one other time when we were outside and nobody was around. And since I'm getting on in years, I did not respond to her that time because I was afraid if I got in a fight with her as she attacked, I wouldn't be able to whip her. So I didn't. But this time she made the mistake of attacking me when there were a number of people around. So then I probably took her by surprise by fighting back. That is, verbally. Oh, I grew up fighting. Verbal fighting is my, I am very good at it. So even though I can't whip anybody, I can really sling the words around to hurt people if I need to. Oh my gosh, when you grow up in a fighting family, that's what happens. Oh boy. But after this skirmish, and I fought back, which seemed to surprise her, the upshot of it was that she finally realized that she had picked this fight with a woman 20 years older than she, and in a bunch of people witnessing it. And the assistant manager was attracted to the verbal exchanges and came and had to stop it. So she treated us like a couple of brawlers that she told me, you better stay away from each other. And I said, well, I plan to. And then she said, but I said I was just walking through the lobby, minding my own business, and this woman picked a fight with me. So I'm totally not to blame. Oh, well, that doesn't stop people from blaming you anyway. Just because you happen to be a formidable debater, is what I would call it. I am a debater. If someone comes at me with a heated argument, oh, I've had a lot of experience coming back up. Just ask the people that's been in a heated debate with me. So, anyway, the upshot of this was, is what it always happens with fights, is it gets very boring. Very boring when everybody's on the fight. They can't talk, they're all mad, you go five people and they're going. And, I'd say, okay, bye. So what? I just hate it when this complex is all broken up into warring factions. These are mad at these people over here. And, it's so boring. Fighting is very boring. It's a waste of energy, as far as I'm concerned. Got all heated up and mad and yelling. Now, as soon as you start yelling, then you're going to have to get over it. That's going to be your enemy every time you meet. This war is no fun. So anyway, this complex is at war, I would say, war with each other, war. this faction is fighting this faction, and this has been done by people that are just sold on war. They just love to fight with people, and you can't stop them. They just, I hate that one, and I hate that one. I'll hate them till I die, and so on. So, to me, it's a very old, an ancient way of human beings not getting along. And I think civilized people finally begin to realize that this is just a waste, an absolute waste. Nobody's having any fun. They're too mad to have fun. They're all too steamed up over what so-and-so said and did over there, and so-and-so did this. And so even though I grew up fighting, I didn't like it. I just thought, this is dumb. And I thought people who are civilized and smart, they learn how to live life another way besides fighting with everybody. That's, like I said, that's just dumb. And so I thought, when this woman insisted on fighting with me, I thought, oh, for heaven's sake. Oh, well, here we go again. This is what I used to feel when my sister and I had a big fight. Oh, dear, I wish we could stop this fighting, but here we go again. And we'd have a great, big, terrible fight and scream and holler and yell. I could holler at the best of them, you know. I always prided myself I didn't start it. I wasn't the most to blame for the fight. So maybe someday we could. And in fact, this one sister and I did come to an agreement. I mean, I told her, I said, now listen, I'm 80 years old and I cannot risk having a great big fight with you anymore. So I've declared, even though we haven't learned how to get along any better than that, I've declared, no, I will not fight with you anymore. So you're going to have to live with that. And she realized that I was talking sense. And so for my 80th birthday, she gave me the gift of not starting a fight with me anymore, because that's what I requested for my 80th birthday, is no more fighting with her. She said, more or less said, okay. And she might not talk to me as often as I would like, because it's hard for a natural born fighter to talk to people without fighting. They've been fighting all their life. They're going to start, you know, training it. Well, you do this and you do that, you know, criticize. Now that is a word that everybody ought to realize is fighting words. When you try to tell somebody what's wrong with them, well, you do this, because they don't want to hear what's wrong with them most of the time. And that is the best way to start a fight there is, to tell somebody what is wrong with them. And because they want to turn around to tell you what's wrong with you. And you're very likely not going to want to hear that. What's wrong with you is a lot worse to hear than when you're telling them what's wrong with them. Well, every fight I've ever seen, they were busy telling each other what was wrong with each other. That's basically what a fight is all about. You did this, 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 and you did this, and this, and this. So anyway, I've survived another fight. See, I don't have any bruises. We didn't get the blows. They stopped us, which I figured. There were enough people around that if we got carried away, they would prevent us from hurting each other very badly. And I told her that she lost her temper with me another time, and now here she's losing it again. picking a fight. So what was it, the deal with her? Why was she determined, absolutely determined to fight? Wasn't she, well, I kind of implied, can't we find another way to talk to each other besides raising our voices? Say, you did it, you did that. I can guarantee you, if you do that to almost anybody, they will probably get mad, and you can have a good old fight. Good old fight. Good old fight. It's very hard to keep from saying those remarks. And people that are always fighting with people, they're past masters at getting in a fight and seeing reason to fight. Now, that's a reason to fight. That's a reason for me never to get over this, to have a feud to our dying day. Stuff like that. Don't worry. Shows these people, well, no, maybe I better not say anything. I better not get too insulting or they're going to come after me and have another fight with me. See how when you're not even trying, you can set it up for another fight. So easy. Just by saying a little bit too much about your opposition, someone you are not getting along with, that they can hear about and get mad at. Like me, in these videos, you know, I could easily say too much and get somebody absolutely furious. And when I'm on Facebook, I write. I've been a writer for years, and I could very easily write something that somebody read it and they would get very angry and decide that was a declaration of war. So you see, when you're not even trying, if you don't watch every step you make and every word that you not only speak, but you write and you say in a video, is a declaration of too much for that person over there or over here to stand, and they're going to come back at you. So, these are just a few suggestions that I'm giving on trying to leave a life of fighting. And, you know, because this becomes necessary at a certain age. You just can't keep on fighting without paying the cost of it. Without, like me, I get chronic fatigue if I fight too much. I get overly stressed. I was stressed for 3 days over this fight I had in the lobby, which I didn't start, but I'm very anxious to stop this kind of thing because take me 3 days to recover from raising my voice, getting into fighting mode, you know, where get my blood pressure up and all this sort of thing. So it's costly. It's costly. It probably took, I don't know how many days of my life to get into that fight, because there's a toll to a fight, even if you don't get into blows. It's when you raise your voice, you lose your temper. Let's put it there. Now, a debate was a wonderful invention where you weren't supposed to lose your temper. You're just supposed to argue the point in a calm, civilized manner. Now, that's very hard for people to do. If they feel passionately about something, they start raising their voices, they start getting mad. Well, now, think. Getting mad is the first sign that you're out of control. You're not civilized anymore. You've returned to the savage state. So, holding on to your temper and talking in a friendly manner. Like, if this lady had approached me and said, oh, how are you, and smiled, and acted like she wanted to have a discussion with me, Now that would have been a lot better. It would have been hard on my blood pressure. And she say, you know, just friendly. And some people, they pride themselves on fighting. Oh, I'm a fighter. Oh, I'll show her. Well, if you want to prove to people you're a fighter, you're whipped already. If you haven't decided that fighting is dumb, you're lost. You're going to be fighting to the end of time. But you've got to tell yourself that kind of exchange is actually a giving in to your emotions. It's lack of control over your emotions. And you are the only one, really, that can control your own emotions. You're the only one that can decide that you're not going to get mad at this or that. You're not going to be drawn into a heated... But if someone is yelling at you in your face, that is going to be... See, this is what happens to nations. You know, they yell and yell and they... threaten a nuclear, absolute nuclear destruction and all kinds of stuff that causes the other nation to get all upset, and they might start bombing them or doing some other ghastly thing that will destroy the whole world if it continues on. So you see how easy it is to destroy and cause a whole bunch of people to lose their lives and a whole bunch of houses and all kinds of bombs dropped and explosions and death and maiming and lack of control over your emotions. So when I was outside and this lady tried to fight with me, I calmed down, but when there were people around, I attempted to argue with her about some of the stuff she was saying and see if that wouldn't satisfy her to a certain degree, and that she'd had a fight, but and not be too hard, not be too destructive, not say too stuff that you know would send the other person absolutely crazy. I'd rather tear you from limb to limb. You know, there's degrees of stuff you could say in a heated an argument that's got heated. And I will occasionally, very, very seldom will I engage in a heated argument. Very seldom. I've more or less just got to be provoked into it and do it to a certain extent in order to say, now, look, is this better? Is this fight better than a smile, a friendly conversation? Is it better? You get a bad reputation when you pick a fight. You get a reputation for being a sorehead. It's not good. So this is the reason for talking about this is if you say, well, you caused me to lose my temper. And you throw a great big terrible tantrum. Well, you might get away with saying, well, they caused me to lose my temper, but you can't use that excuse on and on and on. People are going to say, no, you're the one with the temper. You've proved that you can't control your own temper. So you can't blame it on to the people that lost their temper on the other side. And me, you know, I was very careful not to pick up any fight with her. I never say a word to her that would be considered a fight, combative, make her mad. No, I'm not going to do that. Because I stopped fighting. It's just not what I'm going to do. So she starts trying to fight with me, it's her fault. And she'd get known as doing this. Now, that's not good. That's not good. So, all the people in here that, that start fights, they know who they are. They don't want to admit it, but they can't stop fighting, and they try to blame it on the other people. But we know who they are. And we know they cause a lot of problems in here. But they can't stop fighting. They can't change their ways. They can't give up something that is that just doesn't produce enough good to do, to defend, to keep doing. That's my opinion about fighting.